Rain and thunderstorms to bring flash and riverine flood concerns through parts of WA and NT. And firstly, we have flood watches current for large parts of WA and western parts of the Northern Territory. Now, this means if you live in this highlighted area or know someone that does, we could see heavy rainfall lead to flash flooding and possible riverine flooding in these areas. But of more concern is many of our roads in this area are dirt. So this rainfall could lead to flooded and muddy roads, making roads impassable, leading to road closures and possible isolation of residents and communities in this area, and travel problems as well if you are moving through this area. Now, what's causing this? We can see on the satellite image a big band of cloud streaming across WA and the Northern Territory, and that's thanks to an upper trough combining with moist tropical air across the north to bring widespread cloud and rain activity, and that's likely to continue as we move through today, tonight and Monday and Tuesday. Now, in the 24 hours to 9 o'clock this morning, we've already seen quite a few falls in the 30 to 50 millimetre range. Adelaide River had around 70 millimetres this morning, and a lot of our falls for the Pilbara area saw widespread 30 to 50 millimetres, and we're likely to see more of that in the coming days. And we can look at that in more detail as we move through the rest of today into tomorrow. Widespread rain and storm activity continuing across much of northern WA and starting to creep into western parts of the NT as we move into Monday morning. Now, as we go through the day on Monday, we're continuing to see widespread shower and thunderstorm activity. Now, some of these storms could be severe on Monday with heavy rainfall and damaging winds. And some of that rain also starting to extend into western parts of South Australia, though falls will be much lighter there. Then, as we move into Monday night and Tuesday, we're continuing to see rain and storms spreading across WA and the Northern Territory, but also down through parts of South Australia. And then by the time we get into the midweek frame, some of that moisture could start moving into southeastern parts of the country there. But the focus really will be through central and northern parts of the country. Now, let's see how much rainfall in total we're expecting. Widespread falls of 25 to 50 millimetres is likely through much of northern WA and western parts of the NT. But of most concern is along the NT-WA border, where you can see these brighter numbers in the 50 to 150 millimetre range, and that could lead to some possible major impacts there, particularly for our dirt roads, and we could have a fair bit of standing water as well. While these falls aren't unusual in the wet season, they are pretty unusual for this time of year. So please, if you're out and about, take note of weather conditions through northern parts of WA and western parts of NT in the coming days. And remember to get the latest forecasts and warnings via our website, app and social media.